my favorite mayfly. I have quite the interesting bounty for you, if you're interested. Created a maniac, if you can believe it. Sergeant Vance was trained by Rosetta as an elite sniper, and he clearly put his skills to good use. Even I was shocked when I received the report. Over 20 souls taken by this madman's gun. After investigating, I discovered that he's guilty of all charges. It's Jim Chandler, an old Union sheriff. He realized that a number of travelers were vanishing out in the wilderness. Once he started investigating, he discovered that all the victims were felled not by vulture gangs or deviants, but by bullets fired from the same sniper rifle. Once he determined the killer's identity, Sheriff Chandler found the murderer's hideout and went there alone to arrest Sergeant Vance. Alas, the arrest was unsuccessful. Old Chandler was seriously injured and withdrew to Tallgrass. While on his deathbed, he commissioned a bounty from me for the murderer.
Actually, I rather miss Jim Chandler. When he was still alive, he'd come and discuss issues of law, morality, justice, all those sorts of things with me.
Our talks really touched me and helped me improve my operations. He truly was not just a friend, but a teacher. It's a pity that the old sheriff was so honest. He had no real money left and could only leave me these batteries for the bounty. A rather low price for a killer from Rosetta. But for Sheriff Chandler, I decided to make an exception.
Who's there? much time, but I want to ask you a question. Yes, I know. Good job taking out that scumbag, but more importantly, I want you to tell me, if you were approaching a suspect before you had all the evidence and he pulled out a gun, what would you do? Here I thought you'd follow the law to the letter, just like T-Man always preaches. Was I mistaken? Then remember, Mayfly, next time you execute a bounty, make sure you're doing it in a way that leaves that conscience of yours clear. That's all right. T-Man, my business here is finished. You can give it to...
As you wish, Sheriff Chandler. A sheriff's hat. And his position. When Sheriff Chandler issued the bounty, he had a special request. If anyone successfully fulfilled it, I'd let him interview his successor. It seems that Sheriff Chandler is quite pleased with you. So, maybe, I should say, Sheriff, this hat is yours. Our mission to eradicate the evil in this world is thriving. We are bringing justice. But I doubt our client, Mr. Clay, would merit much sympathy. He was a vulture. To be more precise, the former head of a vulture gang. Quite an effective criminal, if I may say so myself. Capable of killing someone for a can of food without blinking. It's simple. His bounty meets the procedural standards of justice. Clear evidence provided. Crimes committed, allegations proven. The target deviant is indeed guilty of terrible crimes. Here's the bounty case file. You can see for yourself. Mr. Clay has a clear connection to the deviant in question.
Now, I understand you may have doubts about the client's motives, but I assure you that carrying out this bounty will achieve justice in every sense. Although sometimes, of course, people may see an unusual way to benefit from filing a bounty. There is a gentleman who is a particular beneficiary of this bounty, but I can tolerate it in this case.
Thank you. You son of a bitch! No! No, damn you, no! Don't devour me! I'm begging you, don't! No!
Another job well done. You truly are an exemplary partner. A better place than this stardust-infested wasteland. Rest assured, I have my very own scales of Anubis within my system. I assess the entire life of all my clients. The innocent find their paradise, while those like Mr. Clay, well, they end up somewhere far away. Somewhere eternal and unexplainable. Somewhere that suits them. There you go. I do so look forward to working with you again.